Welcome to IntoCraft channel. In this video I'm going to talk about mechanical check of a laser engraving machine. In case we have an unpacked laser machine or our machine needs maintenance, first step before doing anything else is to check if the machine parts are properly functional, X and Y carriages move freely but not loose. If you've been using the laser for a while, it's time to clean all the moving parts. If you have just got a new laser, then continue watching. You would need to do this soon. In a few minutes, you will also see how to adjust the tension in the belt and set the eccentric nut. I've loosened the belt since I've been using the machine and it's needed maintenance, and removed totally from the X carriage so its carriage can freely move to the left and right. Next step is to clean the wheels, belts and the gears on the stepmother with cotton pads or cotton swabs and dampening it with the drawing alcohol. Put the cotton pads on the wheels and press gently and move the carriage to the sides. Go back and forth. This way you can clean all around the wheels. Do not forget to clean the rails and the edges, especially where the wheels move along. It will help to improve the wheel's traction and reduce the carriage's friction when moving on the rail. If the wheels are loose or tight, you may use the eccentric nut to adjust the pressure on the wheels. If the eccentric nut was not adjusted correctly, you can feel the wheel is loose inside the rail and the carriage can shake back and forth. Turn the eccentric nut a little bit and try moving the carriage. It should not move so freely and it should not be hard to push it to the sides. If it sounds okay, then try holding the carriage and spin the wheels with your thumb. The wheel should not spin freely but should not be so tight that you cannot move it with the pressure of your thumb. Repeat the whole process, what you have done so far for the other carriages, and remember to remove the belt every time that you want to adjust the wheel's traction by the eccentric nut. Now that the carriages are set to have the right traction to the rails, it's time to mount the belts back on. Fix the belts on one side of the machine if it's already not fixed. Pass the belt through the carriage and move the slider to the end where the belt was fixed. Remember to check that the belt tooth are properly matched to the gear of the stepmower. Pull the free end of the belt by hand and check how freely or by force the carriage is moving toward the ends of the rail. Neither it should move freely nor with high force. Check the elasticity of the belt on both sides of the gear. It should not be solid tight and it should not be loose, that both sides may meet each other and in future they may slip the gear. Repeat the same procedure for the other belts and carriages. Try to run an example like this with different size of squares, circles, letters, vertical and horizontal scanning lines, or download the file from the below link. Your machine is ready now for the first test to check how straight and curved lines are engraved as they are supposed to look. The line method is selected for engraving of all the lines and curves. A low speed in range of 500 to 600 mm per minute or 10 mm per second is a representative cut speed that you may use in the future. If you may use higher speed, try to run the same file with that speed and check the stability of your machine. There are two squares to check the horizontal and vertical field lines. Select a high line interval value. To be able to differentiate the lines after the burn, set the scanning angle to zero for a horizontal scan. I've used the same settings for the other field square, but 90 degrees for a scanning angle to engrave vertical lines. So So let us check the output, which is the engraving we should expect to see after running this file. The two fill squares in the bottom right corner may show how the scanned lines are engraved. Next is to save the Gcode to an SD card, or you may run it directly from the software and push it to a machine. So let's start a laser. And open the file. Frame it to be sure that we are in the right spot and right size that we want to engrave. All good here. Then run it. After the engraving is done, we go and have a closer look to the results of our engraving. As you can see, all the lines and the circles, also the curves, has been engraved nicely, and we are all good to go. This means the traction of the wheels to the rails and also the tension on the belt has been set correctly. If you have got the same result, it means that you have done it also correctly. Otherwise, you need to go back to a step 3 and start adjusting the eccentric nut and the tension on the belt. I should add a comment to the fill squares. You may also have noticed that the lines are not aligned. This is the setting that you may want to watch the next episode about the scanning offset. Thanks for watching, and hope that it has been helpful for you.